Good evening, kids. Today's class in the ray optics chapter, in the plane mirrors, we're going to discuss about the what is the minimum length needed of a mirror to see one's own full image. It means a person standing in front of a mirror, what is the minimum length of the mirror required? Then some applications like I'll stand in front of a mirror and I look behind the wall. I want to see the complete wall, the image of that wall in the mirror, then what should be the length of the mirror needed? This one. Or two persons standing in front of mirror and they want to see each other completely in the mirror, their images. So these are some, and if a mirror is in motion or if the source is in motion, what will happen to the spot? So these are some problems related of these kind of what I'm just picked up in today's class. Okay, let me take you to the screen. Okay, today's in the chapter ray optics, numericals on plane mirror, the part B. Previous class it was part A, that one. Okay, what is the general methodology in the physics? Practice numericals, remember all the important ideas or the formulas. Try to work out different numericals. That's what accept challenges. And anybody can do it. If you put effort, you can do it. Okay, try to follow this general method, the physics. So as long as you do problems, different types of numericals, the confidence will come. Just mere reading theoretical information may not help you. Now we know laws of reflection. Can you really think, can you solve all the problems? No. Again, you have to practice numericals really to understand the application part. So the numericals plays very important role in physics. Okay, let's begin the Let me adjust the things. Yeah, okay, fine. Yeah. Oh, no. Okay, we'll begin our discussion. Okay, there's a person standing in front of a plane mirror. Is a person. And there's a length of mirror. What is the minimum length of the mirror that is required to see one's full image, to is complete image? What do you mean by complete image? You must able to see his foot as well as his head. So the distance from the head to high will be usually 1/10 of the height of the person is what we are assuming it. Let H be the height of the person. What should be the length of the mirror? What is the basic necessity condition here? So to see his full image, the rays emitted by foot after striking the mirror, if they enter into eye, as he is able to see the foot. The rays emitted by his ears on head after striking mirror, if they enter into eye, then he is able to see his ears. What about other parts? Yes, the other parts also. Now we'll get into the ray diagram. There's a question. I'll directly here only. Let me take the ray diagram. So what the ray diagram says is like, the rays emitted by the head should enter into eye. Then the rays emitted by the foot after reflection should enter into eye. Then with this, if this condition is satisfied, okay, agree this. So there's everything. Let me show it in a very simplified diagram. There's a person, no? You may find little bit difficult. So this is what is head, eye, and this is foot. The mirror which was under consideration, it will be here. Okay, now we'll start with the rays emitted by the head will get reflected at one end of the mirror and they'll enter into eye. The rays emitted by foot after reflection at the lower end of the mirror will enter into eye. Now you can ask questions of how, on what basis you are drawing these things. Now what is a, let this distance be x. Let this distance be y. Any reason for that? Because the angle of incidence must be equal to angle of reflection. The angle of incidence must be equal to angle of reflection. From the laws of reflection, this is m1 and m2. So what is the length of the mirror needed? X plus y. Means now, is the person is able to see his foot? As he can say that I'm wearing the some black color shoes, he can say, oh, my ears are somewhat not complete dark gray color. Like this, the person can comment after looking himself in the mirror and is able to see his ears and also his foot. So what this person will comment? Mm-hmm. I'm seeing my foot, I'm seeing my feet and also my ears. He's able to comment, he's able to visualize. How it is possible in this one? What about the other parts of body? Means can he see only the ears and feet? Even this also. What about this three? Will enter. So I think this will be very, very important for a student to really learn. So I'll show by a solid line. What about the other part? Is able to see his knee? Okay, knee will be somewhere here. Yes, the knee also is able to see it. Sir, what about his belly? Yes, his belly also, he will be able to see that one. He can see his belly also. Let me take the yellow color line. Is the feet. Okay, these are the eyes. Head or ears, anything it can be, huh? Getting the idea, no? So it's not that, see, we are just bothered. If he's able to see his foot, means he's able to see his knees, he's able to see his belly, he's able to see his, chest, lap, all the things. See, if he's able to see his ear, means he's able to see his forehead also. I'm seeing my feet and also my ears, or what he should comment. Total body I'm seeing my I'm seeing my total body this word. So now let's get into the mathematics. So what is this distance? This is x. So this x plus, so here, okay, yeah, this is y. So x plus y should be equal to lm. Looking at this triangle, what is this distance? Overall x plus y should be equal to lm. So what is the length of the mirror needed? What is the height of the person? 2x plus 2y. So therefore, so this is a minimum length. If the length is no sir, I'll increase this length. Okay, you increase. I'll bring the other part of the lens. I'll add some other segment of length, like a mirror here. Then what happens? Still he will able to see that one. This is a minimum length. To see himself completely in the mirror. Okay, fine. Okay, no, after getting this, so what this person will do is like this particular length of mirror, no, he is going to place on the ground. Then we'll see what conditions will come. The same thing. In this case, will he able to see himself completely? We have to really analyze the situation, sir. We have to really analyze and fight with the conditions available. Now, as usual, the terminology. So this will be edge. Mm-hmm. Let me go for pen. No, this is his edge. This eye, and this is his foot. Now, lower end of the mirror. Upper end of the mirror is M1, M2. It is on ground. Both the person. What is the length of the mirror? He has took it to be h by 2. Okay, what all will be visible for him? See, what is the basic condition? The rays, the rays from the foot will go and get reflected. Means what part of the body will be visible? The rays emitted by the body when they fall on the mirror, and the reflected rays if they enter into eye, is the person is able to see himself. New means the rays emitted by different parts of the body when they are incident on the mirror, after reflection, those rays, if they enter into eye, then corresponding to those reflected rays, the person is able to see himself. That is a basic necessity. No. Next question comes, why person will emit light? I think he is not a luminous person. No? Then what actually happens? Maybe standing in sunlight, or maybe in a room, he has switched on the tube light, the light coming from the electric bulb will fall on the person, get reflected, then will fall on the mirror, then it will enter into his eyes, then he is able to see himself. In pitch dark room, no light will be incident on person, and there won't be any reflected light by the person, and no light will reach the mirror, and no question of seeing himself. Getting the background now, that's the basic idea. Let's assume that some sunlight is falling on him. Okay, now the rays coming from the, I'll just start in the little bit way like this. So this is a ray. Is it possible? What are the basic conditions? The angle of incidence should be equal to angle of reflection. Now look at this, total height of the person is h, and height of the mirror is h by 2. I kept it. So definitely this would be the midpoint of h, this one. And what about here? This will be h by 2, no? So this should be h by 2. So the definitely the rays will reach here. So what is the correction I should make it here now? These rays in fact will not reach his eye, will strike his forehead or will strike his ears. So what is the condition here? The same basic idea. Now the rays emitted by his able to make it out. So what is this distance? This will be again h by 10. What will be visible for the person? Yes, kept that particular mirror on the ground. No. Look at the rays emitted by his arms. Cannot reach his eye, no. So the rays emitted by his left arm will go strike and will reach it. The rays emitted by his chest will reach it. So the rays emitted by various parts of the body after striking mirror, if they enter into eye, the person is able to view himself. Now, what part will be visible is what we have to check it here now. How to judge this one? No. So what part will be visible? So only this particular point will be visible, not even his foot. only one point. He's unable to see his ears. So this is, will not be visible. It's his nose or this one is chest, arms, belly. This will not be visible. His foot will not be visible. Only this particular point. The rays emitted by this part of his pant or lapin is able to enter the eye. What about here? These rays will not enter. You check it. Not this length. Only this particular point is what visible. Very dangerous, no? The same mirror, if it was somewhere here, we are able to, is able to himself completely, that one. Is able to view himself completely. So therefore, now what is the condition now? Only this particular point will be visible. Only point P on his pants is visible. Okay, getting now. So why the dressing table? So if you look at the basic design of dressing table, so how do that? I think some most of you might have come across that dressing table. Why the mirror should be if this day dressing table? This is basically mirror, and will go for some wood for its protection. Then ear will give cupboards, no? And it will be placed at height. Why it should be placed at a certain height? The reason is the earlier problem. If the mirror, minimum length of mirror, what happened? If you go for minimum length, no, if it is rise to certain height from the ground, then what happened? The minimum length is sufficient to see one's his full image. This is a typical dressing table, what you notice. This will be our mirror. So if it just rise, if it rise to an height, no, then the minimum length will be sufficient. So suppose if you place on the ground, no, only one point will be visible. This will be more dangerous. Okay, now let's take a situation where the height of the mirror is, the length of the mirror is 3h/4. Then what all will be visible, we'll check it. Again, the necessary condition is the HE, head, eye, and this is foot, equal to h/10. Or you can neglect that HE is equal to directly with I, we can discuss the problem. Like previous problem, I made HE equal to h/10. If you want, you can avoid that h/10. So you usually this distance will be very small. We can neglect it. Let me not take that one directly. Or okay, we'll continue. Nothing is there. No. What will be visible for him? So those rays emitted by the eye, so like emitted by the body, like this, some rough ray diagram is what I'm taking. What about his foot? The rays emitted by foot after reflection, they can enter into eye. Like this will have some rough diagram. Now, any other ray which is somewhere here will enter into eye. There's no problem. So this part of the body is visible. What about this? Will not be visible. So this part of the body, what happened, will be visible from his arm to till his foot, what happened, will be visible. So this much of length of the body will be visible for him. Okay, take this one. So the distances will be, this is x, and the distance is y. This you can take it y. We'll go for some indication of the thing. Okay, let this be. Let me draw one more separate. H/4. This distance, I'll assume it to be h only, because a lot of calculations will get involved. H is equal to 0. Is I, will let it be the distance between his ears and the I, let it be very small, so we can take it to be I, that one. So our calculations will get simplified. So now we know this distance is 3h/4, and we know this distance is h. Unnecessary more calculations will get involved. So this is his I, this is a foot, so this is m1, this is m2. What was our question? What length of the body will be visible? So from the diagram, okay, this should be the θ1. θ1. So what is this length? This remaining length will be h/4. So this will be h/4. So now this remaining length will be h/2. Now his foot will be visible. Yes, his foot will be visible. We need to, it will be that one. So shall we say that this part of the body will be visible? Y length. Y length of the body, the person will see. Let me write the sentence properly. Is Y length. What is y? Y should be equal to, shall we write h/2? The person sees h/2 length of, the person sees h/2 length of his body, image in mirror. It's a very simplified way. So the moment if make h equal to 0, h equal to 0 means usually I will be just below the forehead. No, so this distance matters. So to make it problem simple, we made h equal to 0. So what length of the body will be visible? This is able to see his foot, his knee, his lap. He's unable to see his belly or what belt is wearing, the buttons, the chest. All these are not visible. What about, sir, why is like a elbow is not visible here? So the rays emitted by the elbow after striking the mirror will not reach eye. You can see here, where the rays from somewhere here, you can see that this one can reach eye. It can reach eye. So let me show some other color, some black color line. Let me take it so you can see very much possible. Getting this one? So like this is what we have to draw the ray diagram. See, there is no formula here. The students will try to think formula. You have to analyze through a ray diagram here. So shall I write, this is what the visible part. And what is this? This is equal to h by 2. What be comment? I'm able to see the lower half of the body. So the person will comment, lower half of the body. I'm able to see my lower half of the body's image in mirror. That will be his comment. Okay, let's take the next condition. Is it advisable? I think, length of the mirror 3h by 4 is unable to see his upper half. If the length of the mirror is h by 2, is able to see himself completely. The reason the mirror should be raised certain height from the ground. Are you able to see this? This is a ground. These problems are very important. This is a ground. So if you just lift the mirror from the ground, what happened? The minimum length, h by 2, that is sufficient. He's able to see himself completely. But if the same mirror, if you place on the ground of length h by 2, he's able to see only his point P. Now 3h by 4, S, he's able to see this part. Okay, these are some problems what he'll encounter. Okay, yeah, now we'll take this one. No. So there is again, we'll make this one, lot of calculations will be there. We'll make it, this will be like a I and this will be foot. So problems will become easy for us. I know, what is the, what part of the body is able to see himself? Okay, the rays emitted by the, let me take H only, no problem. The rays emitted by Z after reflection will enter into I. Next, the simile. What all will be visible? Now H, E, let me write some terms. So this is E. Let me bring some reference line. This is E. This is his what? I. Oh. Ah. Okay, no. H, E. So what will be visible? F. Okay, this is A. I'll write it B. So, or else we'll take the diagram here. The person, no, little bit difficult. So this was the length of the mirror. Okay, now I'll show all the things clearly through the diagram. The ray is emitted by is head will reach eyes. This is what the mirror, no? So that's why in the books, no, they avoided drawing the person because you can see that one. Again, we have to come back to this diagram only. So this we know what is the length. Length is equal to hm by 4. So this let it be x, x, y, and y. Total height of the person is h. So what is the remaining distance will be 3h by 4. So what is he? The 2x will be h by 4. Okay, this length is what? H by 4 there. So this is h, e. Okay, this is a foot. So what is he value? He value is equal to h by 10. So therefore 2x is equal to, so what we can write? This part 2x should be equal to h by 10 or x equal to h by 20. Can we calculate the y in h by 4? X plus y should be equal to h by 4. So x is equal to how much? H by 20. So therefore the y is equal to h by 4 minus h by 20. X is equal to h by 10. H is equal to okay, fine. This will become h, 4 I'll take outside, 1 minus 1 by 5. H by 20 is what visible? Calculations correct. 4 if I take 5. 5 minus 1, 4, 4, 20. H by 20. So what is the value of y? Y will be again equal to h by 20. H by 10 it should be, no? 2x plus. Okay, we'll see this one. We're getting y equal to also h by 20. Yeah? Let me check it. Okay, fine. So y is equal to h by 2. So what is the part of the body that is visible? Length of the I to write some sentence. Okay, let me put it here. Length of body length of image of body as seen in mirror. How much it should be equal to? This, let me write L or capital L. This should be equal to 2x plus 2y. What is 2x equal to? 2x should be equal to h by 10. 2y, this one. So h by 10 plus h by 10, h by 5. Okay, fine. So this is the length of the body. What happened? That will be visible for that one. H by 5. 1/5 of the is body. What happened? Will be visible. Able to make it out? This one. So shall we say FC will be visible? No, FC will not be visible. Now what will be visible? Visible will be HC will be visible. Agree this? So these are just some triangles is what we have to apply it. Laws of angle of incidence should be equal to angle of reflection. Angle of incidence should be equal to angle of reflection. And this total length is what? H by 4. In the H by 4 length, this x plus y should be equal to h by 4. So what is value of x? 2x should be equal to h by 10. So x should be equal to h by 20. That I'm substituting. See the mathematics. So y equal to h by 4 minus h by 20. One by four minus 1/20. 1/4 will be 0.25. The some calculations went wrong. Okay, so this one. So here is very simple. This should be h/5. Am I right? Or I'll put one more. So h/4 will become 5 minus 1, 4. 4/5. I think so it will impact on the total result. This will be h/5 because from diagram these two angles will be different. Okay, y equal to h/5, we get it. Okay, h by 2x equal to h/10, and this will become 2h/5. Okay, now we'll see this. I'm not that good in calculation, to be frank. Usually in class, no, the students will do. So this will be 1/2 + 2, h/5. So this will become 2 × 4, 5, 5. Oh, we are getting h/2. Huh? Yeah. h/2 length is what will be visible. So this will not be visible. Half of the body will not be visible. Remaining of will be not visible. Visible. Getting some idea? So these are the ways in which the questions can be asked here. So again, FC not visible, SC will be visible. Half of his body will be the length of the image of body as seen in mirror. So what we have to write, comment? Yeah, fine. It will be this much. Okay, just take care about calculation. I felt somewhere I'm, because the theta 1, theta 2 will be different, no? So therefore, X and Y must, X should not be equal to Y. And what is the basic idea here? Also, h is equal to h/10. The answers will change. If h is almost negligible, then answers will slightly change. No. Okay, this is a very good question. I am trying to test you with. Let me draw a fresh line. Look at now. What is the question like? Let me read the question. Hope I think by this time everyone is able to understand my handwriting. Find the length of the plane mirror so that a person looking into the mirror is able to view the complete image of rear wall of height h. This is a wall. So what this person, he should able to see the complete wall. The image of the wall he should able to see. See, if he turns, he can see the wall. What is the condition? What should be the length of the mirror so that the complete wall should be visible through the mirror? What should be the length of the mirror? earlier we discussed about himself, no, for the person himself. So now we have changed a little bit condition here. What is your approach? I think I should allow you to really think on this particular problem. What should be the generalized approach? The ray is emitted by the top end of the wall and the bottom end of the wall. After reflection with the mirror, should enter into the eye. Then only is able to see himself. So then only is able to see the wall completely. I think this is a condition. Let me take you to the diagram. No, what your physics teacher is trying to stress in a very simplified, the ray emitted by the bottom of the wall after reflection should enter into eye. The ray emitted by the top end of the wall after reflection with the upper end of the mirror should enter into the eye. I think if this condition is satisfied, then what this person will commit? I'm able to see the total wall, which is behind me. How to do such problems? See, you can, lot of mass will be involved. So nothing but what happened, the reflected ray should enter into eye, no? So where this particular mirror, there's a mirror. What this mirror does, it should form the image of wall, and that image should be visible for the person. So I will take a totally simplified approach. So if you are interested, you can fight with the mathematics here. So we'll just go for a very simplified approach. We need not to struggle. So if this is the wall, okay, then. There's a mirror. Let me show that mirror here. Oh. Yeah. Now see this. There's a mirror. So where do this mirror will form? Its image will be formed here at equal distance. I think I'm very sure these two lengths will be equal. So this length is equal to L. This length also should be equal to L. And what is the H? Okay, what is this? This is a wall. What is this? This is the image of wall. Formed by mirror. And the person, Let it be somewhere here. Okay, the ray is emitted. Proportionally, let me adjust the Let me adjusting. Okay, this is the mirror. Yeah, no. Okay, this eye, no. The person eye should enter his eye. Okay, here, let me take the So this length, let it be X, this is Y. Theta 1, theta 2. We know this distance. This is what? Eta L. And this is the total height of the mirror. So let me write it. This is H1, this is H2. And this should be equal to what? H, again in turn. H1 plus H2, in fact, must be equal to H. So what was our question? The length of the mirror. What is the length of mirror? Length of the mirror will be X plus Y only. So this is the mirror. But sir, you can ask questions, sir. What you made something like, see this, as if now the rays emitted by the wall after reflection at the end of the mirror will enter into eye. This rays, as if they are coming from here, no? Both are same. So I'm just making the image. I'll bring the image of the wall here. Let the rays emitted by the image. What are this ray? The rays emitted by the also like these are the reflected rays, no? So from where do it should come? It should be diverging from the image. So I'm bringing here. So what is this? This one, this is the image of wall formed by the mirror. This is one approach. See, we are supposed to work out here. A lot of mass is involved. We have just got a simplified approach here. X plus Y is what? Length of the mirror. Let me write symbols. A, B. Got it now? Okay, just let's write. Look at the triangle. So which triangle you have to look at? You have to look at this triangle. There are two triangles, similar triangles are there. This is one similar triangle. And this is also a similar triangle. So tan theta 1 should be equal to x by eta l should be equal to h1 by l plus eta l. See things carefully. This length is l because object distance should be equal to image distance. The wall was at a distance L from the mirror. So its image should also be at a distance L. So what can be this total length? L plus this length is eta L. Okay, we wanted H1. So the L will get eliminated. This will become, we wanted X, no? So X should be equal to H1 eta by 1 plus eta. Similarly, lower triangle, tan theta 2 should be equal to Y by eta L. H2 by L plus eta L. Now, what is this equation from where I brought it? So looking at this triangle. Tan theta 2 opposite H2 adjacent, how much adjacent will be L plus eta L. Similarly, looking at this two are similar triangles. So tan theta 2 here, opposite is Y, adjacent is eta L. What is the length of the mirror? The length of the mirror is should be equal to how much? H1 plus H2 eta by 1 plus eta. What is H1 plus H2? Should be H. Okay, some equations are there. We should able to now interpret. What do you mean by that? Where I took I? Look at the position of I. It's independent of position of I, no? Because it's not coming something like a, what is the height of the mirror? This length is not coming. The final answer, it is independent of height of the mirror. At what height the mirror located from the ground, or what is the position of height, irrespective of that. If I is exactly the midpoint, this is like a room, no? Eta L and L, we took it. Suppose if I is exactly the midpoint, then eta will become 1 by 2, substitute 1 by 2. Then you get some length of the mirror. Means where between, so the length of the mirror needed, what happened? It depends upon the position of I between the wall and the mirror. So usually what happened? It will be just lying. So what is this entire question will be like? Is it a vertical wall? No, this is like a horizontal wall. This is like a width actually, to be frank. And the mirror is kept and the person is the difference. So this will be the ground. This is not the ground. That's why I didn't try this as a ground. Little bit some conditions are here. Instead of this, like or no sir, let it be ground. Okay, no problem, still you can manage. If exactly the midpoint between the wall and the mirror, so then put eta equal to 1/2, then look at the length of the mirror. So in the diagram, I'm showing that the person is on the like some sort of a ground, no? Okay, now if it's exactly the midpoint between the wall and the mirror, okay, then put eta equal to 1/2, then you get the length of the mirror. So shall I say that as he changes his position, eta will change, the length of the mirror requires also will change. And let's take few more. Look at the read question. There's a father of height h and his child is of height h by 2. And both are, the child is between the father and the mirror. That this AB is a mirror. So we'll indicate. So what is the question that is asked? So the child is at a distance D from the mirror and the father is at a distance 2D, 3D from the mirror. What is the minimum length of the mirror required so that the child can completely see his father's image in the mirror? I think it is similar to like a previous wall one. The same idea is what I can apply here again. So again, we'll neglect that. Like a distance from the is head to is eye. Let it be everywhere. We'll take it eye this one. Okay, the diagram, we'll make it a simplified one. This is his father, and this is a child or a kid, exactly height h by 2. Distance 2D, no? And there's a mirror. And this is a mirror. Okay, no, doesn't looks like h by 2. Let me adjust the distances. Half of the height. Will increase for the side little bit. Yeah. Okay, no. what is the condition? The image should be. I think I can't. I'll make it small so that I can. There's a father, H, there's a kid, so here is a child, there's a father. Now, where the image of father should be at a distance 3D. Rough diagram, because we need a geometrical instrument to exactly predict. Okay, no, the rays emitted by the foot of his father should fall on the, after striking the end B of the mirror, will enter into I. Similarly, the rays emitted by head of the father after striking the end A of the mirror will enter into the I. Then the person, what happened, they say that, yes, I'm able to see my father completely. This will be the condition. So here we'll make it the same condition, the rays after emitted by the let me form the diagram completely, then I'll come to the explanation. Yeah, come for this one. What is this? This is the image of water. Watch beat sight. If suppose that this is like a mirror is here AB. This is a child. The height of the image of water should be H, because like the mirror will not produce any magnification. As such, we know. Show that this is the, yeah, this one. So this distance is how much? This was D, 2D. This will be 3D. I think our problem, same previous problem, what we did is the same analysis is what you have to do. This will be theta 1, theta 2. This is X, this is Y. Got the idea? Now, what is AB? Length of the mirror is equal to AB, which is equal to X plus Y. Somehow you have to calculate X and Y. So this is H1, this is H2. Okay, let's get into the calculation part. what is tan theta 1? Tan theta 1 should be X by D at the same time. Tan theta 1, I'm asking you to look at this triangle. Tan theta 1 should be equal to opposite by the adjacent. So X by D. Similarly, look at the bigger triangle. Tan theta 1 should be equal to opposite by the adjacent. What is adjacent? D plus 3D. So opposite is H1, D plus 3D. So H1 should be equal to, or X should be equal to H1 by 4. Similarly, take help of this triangle. So your tan theta 2 should be equal to opposite by adjacent. So tan theta 2 should be equal to Y by D. This should be equal to H2 by, so Y equal to H2 by 4. So what we are having, X plus Y equal to H1 by 4, H2 by 4. H1 plus H2 by 4. So what is H1 plus H2 should be equal to H? So what is the length of the mirror needed now? H by 4. Okay, let me check the calculation. I'm not very good in calculation. Tan theta 1. This should be the 2D and D. This is height H by 2. Okay. Yeah. This is correct. Yeah. Yeah, fine. No problem. The length of the mirror, tan theta 1 is equal to, let me start here. Tan theta 1 is equal to X by D. At the same time, tan theta 1 should be equal to opposite is H1, H1 by 4D. So therefore, X equal to this much. So again, the similar triangle, tan theta 2 should become equal to Y by Y by D plus H2 4D. So therefore, again, the Y will be equal to sum of these two, H1 by H2, H1 by 4 plus H2 by 4, H1 plus H2, H by 4. Okay, somehow I'm getting the, okay, there was some technical problem. Okay, no. Yeah. So this will be our required length of the mirror. So what is the length of the mirror? The length of the mirror was LM is equal to X plus Y. We got it is equal to H by 4. I think this approach should be very, very, very important. So what is this? Image of water. I think I should shade. The actual water is here. the child, what happened, the actually for the child, what happened when he looks into mirror, what happened, he's going to see his image. Is able to see his total his father. Can you say that I'm able to see my father wearing shoes? Yes, the child will come in because he's able to see his completely his father. Then he said that, okay, my father is having some gray hair. My father is wearing pink shirt, green pants. Yes, the child will comment everything. Because he's able to see totally his father. So what will be the comment from child? I am able to see completely my father through in mirror. What should be the length of the mirror? That is what h/4 we have found out. Okay, similarly, same condition. So if the this should be from here, 2D. No. So height of the person, height of the father is h, and height of the child is h/2. The father is at a distance 3D from the mirror, and the child is at a distance d from the mirror. What should be the total length? What should be the length of the mirror so that the father will see his child completely? Child, the father is able to see the image of child completely in the mirror. Find the minimum length of mirror required so that father can see his child's image completely in the mirror. I think there's a very straightforward. Just know, previous class what we did. I think the same idea shall we bring here. So I will start with this. Okay, there's a father. If you want, I'll take arrow. Okay, inverted arrow. There's a thing. So here is what a child. h/2. Then the mirror. Then the image of that child is what we are putting it here. Okay, this is a child. This is an image of child. Now, who should see? The father should be able to see the image of child completely through this mirror. What should be the length of the mirror that is being asked? So again, the what was our earlier approach like? The rays emitted by the foot of the child after reflection should enter into the eye. The rays emitted by the head of the child after reflection should enter into the eye. Then only then definitely what you can say that the father is able to see the complete image of the child in the mirror. So now instead of working here, instead of fighting in this diagram, lot of mass, will take help of the image of child. So these rays are what happen, reflected rays. So they should diverge from the image. Hope I think I can draw a better diagram. If I'm able to draw, I'll adjust things. Okay, this will be the position of the child. Okay, I think, okay, this arrow should come here, no? Object distance should be coordinate distance. Yeah, okay, fine, here. Yeah. Now, okay, this will be the mirror. I'm not bothered about child. Let me look at only the image of child. So this distance is d, so this should be equal to d, and this is 2d. Okay, let's go for the some small geometry involved with this. What are the other set of rays I needed? These are some. It's a very problematic now. I'm trying my level best to give exact diagram, but still I think without geometrical instruments, getting exact diagram will be very difficult. Okay, fine. Yeah, no. Okay, directly let me get into the calculation part. This is what theta 2 I'll write, theta 1 I'll write, and this angle let it be theta 2. And let this distance be y1. This will be y2. y1 plus y2 is what the needed, no? This is AB. What is the length of the mirror? Length of the mirror is AB, which is y1 plus y2. So what I should do now? I should calculate y1 plus y2. If I can get that and this distance, this should be theta 1 and this should be theta 2. Now, what was our approach here now? This is the reflected ray. We are just taking help of the reflected ray because the reflected rays should diverge from the image. So I'm making it to diverge from the image. Now, y1, y2, can we calculate with the data what we have? SS, we can do. This is h by 2. This is what h by 2, no? And this is h. Looking at the similar triangle, tan theta 1. Okay, we don't know about this. Let me call this is R, this distance. AB, I'll call C. Okay, we know this distance is d, d, and so tan theta 1. I'm asking you to look at this triangle, tan theta 1, h by 4d, h by 4d, at the same time, h by 2 by 2d, so similar triangles. Oh, it cannot be, no? Okay, this triangle. Tan theta 1 will be y r by d. I'm asking you to, because this is not, arrow is not at this particular point. No, this cannot be similar triangle. What are similar triangles? This is one triangle and this another. These are similar triangles. So if you want, I'll give the name P1. Child, no, let me write here. C1, C2. This will be C2 dash, C1 dash. Further, F1, this will be F2. Okay, C dash, F1, F2, similar triangles. C dash, F1, F2, and C dash, CB. From these two triangles, tan theta 1 should be equal to r by d. At the same time, tan theta 1 should be equal to h by 4d. So r equal to h by 4. Okay, got it? Then similarly, so I got the value of R. Now, similarly, I'll go for this triangle. Then this one. So here I'll give the name P, I'll give it. So similar triangle. Similar triangles. C2 dash, P dash, F2 and C2 dash, P and D. So this should be tan theta 2 should be equal to Y1 by D. Opposite will be H2 by H2 by 4D. Y1 is equal to H by 8. But we wanted Y2 know what to do. We know from looking at this data. Y2 plus R should be equal to H by 2. Y2 plus R should be equal to H by 2. What is R? H by 4. So therefore, what is Y2 is equal to H by 4. So what is the length of the mirror? Length of the mirror will be Y1 plus Y2. Y1 is H by 8, H by 4. Okay, this should be the length of the mirror. So this is our answer. Fine. I think it's something you should be very good in now, what like the basic geometry, the similar triangles all. Okay, let's see the ideas how we are taking help of. So what is the approach now? So you can see there's another method. What is that? Here only you get all that angles here. Apply the laws of reflection. Then angle of incidence should be equal to angle of reflection. Here also angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection. So all this, you'll get answer. That will be more lengthy calculations. This is what the books they have proposed. Most of the books. Okay, let me go to the next problem. No, a point source S has been placed as shown in figure. What is the length on the screen that will receive the reflected light from the mirror? It is again based on the ray diagram. Let a ray incident at one end of this angle of incidence should be called angle of reflection. Now we have to draw the diagram properly here also. Then another set of ray will incident here. Angle of incidence should be equal to angle of reflection. Keeping that in mind, the ray should be. So this is what P1, P2. That P1, P2 have to be determined. So here, theta 1. This angle of incidence, theta 2. These two rays will not be parallel. You have to be careful. Now, you produce back these rays. And we know from the mirror concept, if there's an object distance, this should be made distance. Getting the idea, this one. So now he's asking that length P1, P2 has to be determined. So these angles for our calculation purpose. Okay, we'll take this. This is alpha. This should be the alpha. If this is beta, this should be the beta. Are you seeing any similar triangle? Yes, again you are going to take help of the triangles here. So let this be O. Some will use this is A, B, C, and let this be D. Let this be M. And then, so from these two triangles, look at this one. These two triangles will be similar. From similar triangles, so S1 NB and S1 MP2. So tan alpha should be equal to opposite BN by S1N or P2M by S1M. So what is BN? BN should be equal to H. This distance should be equal to H. And even this distance also should be equal to H. From this triangle, this should also be equal to H. P2C should be equal to H. I'll write it here now. Okay, let's get into calculation part. So BN will be H. S1N will be 2H. P2M will be definitely, P2M is asking. Okay, now we'll see what we'll get from calculation. S1M will be 4H. I think it's correct, no? Justified, and P2C should be equal to P2M should be equal to P2C plus CH. I think no need to, from diagram only we can tell it. Okay, let's go for this one. Okay, now I got the P2C. What is P2C? Will be H only. Let's go for these triangles. Now here again a similar triangle will come. M N O P Q R. Okay, N dash. I'll write it. Similar triangles. S dash N dash A and S dash M P 1. Tan beta should be opposite A N dash by N dash S dash. M P 1 by M S dash. Okay, this if you substitute A N dash should be H. N dash S, this should be H. M P dash. Sorry, M P 1. M P 1 we don't know. But M S dash we know it is equal to 4H. So MP1 should be equal to 4H. And we wanted P1C. Okay, this, okay. P1M can be written as P1C plus CM. So MP1 or P1M, that is 4H. P1C we don't know. What is CM? CM is H. So what is P1C? 3H. So what is the length P1, P2? P1, P2 should be equal to P1C minus P2C. P1C is 3H, 2H. Just apply the basic triangle properties there. Okay, where the reflected ray, there's a field of view. Here open, the reflected rays will reach here only. There's a region in which, so what about reflected ray will not reach here. The reflected rays will be present in this region. So what we should call this one as reflected rays are present. the reflected rays are present only in this region. What about here? No reflected ray. Direct ray can come here. There'll be direct ray can be incident in this region. Direct ray can be incident region, but the reflected ray will be present only in this region. This will be our answer. Next, again, we have. Okay, read the question. That there are, I think. Okay, two more questions are there. Well, let me wind up. If I move the spot, there's a mirror. There's a source is there here. There's a source which will emit light. There's a mirror. I'll move the mirror with a velocity, with a speed v in the vertical direction. Now, what are the questions like? What will happen to the length of spot formed on the screen? This is a screen. This is a screen, and the mirror is, let it be at a distance y. So v equal to dy by dt, what we can write it. So what happened to that patch or the bright spot or bright patch formed on the screen? Now, why do the bright patch will be formed? What are the conditions? Because the ray emitted by the source after reflection will fall. Okay, this part of screen will get illuminated. So for different positions, we'll see what conditions will arise. Okay, let me start with the initially. The ray after reflection, we have to follow the laws of reflection here. Fine, this will be. Then next, when the ray goes, strike the other end of the mirror after reflection. It's again a geometry based. You have to see that the angle of incidence should be called angle of reflection here. Angle of incidence should be called angle of, that way you have to draw it. Then again, the mirror will take this position. Okay, let's again send a set of rays. No, I'll send a solid one so that you can see the difference. No. What was earlier length of the patch? the patch length was earlier it was AB. No, A1, B1, and the patch length is A2, B2. And if you look at this distance, will become equal to this. So the length A1, B1, in fact, equal to A2, B2. So what happened, the length of the patch? Remain the same. So the size of the patch remains same, shall we put it? See, now intentionally I'm doing some mistakes so that you can understand, are we really following the laws of reflection? This is the primary question.
you have to really take help of the protractor here. So when you draw it, you have to see that this will be the in fact it will come like this. Now you can ask question, sir, earlier you drew in one way, now you are drawing. How do I can justify that I'm correct here? So I'll take help of okay, this ray diagram is what now is going to help me a lot. Now you can ask questions. Sir, what is this? Earlier you said something and all of a sudden again you changed it. Yes, in fact, see like when you are drawing diagram, you have to follow certain mathematical rules, the laws of physics. The angle of incidence should be equal to angle of reflection. So here, if you look at that angle, theta. I to just see if you find very difficult to take scale and protractor and analyze. The length of the spot will not change. There's nothing called like A1, B1, the spot, what happened, length of the spot, length of the patch, bright patch, or like a length of the bright patch remains same and will not move on the screen. I think it's about the diagram. So what is the, like usually let me take this yellow color source of light. So what we see is like the patch will be this one. So this yellow color, I'm taking the sodium vapor lamp. Then I can definitely on screen, I can see that yellow color patch. Sodium bulb. If you find very difficult, take scale and protractor. Or else through, you should draw a diagram. So you can draw a diagram where you can show wrong, but something you have to be careful with the angles. Got the idea? So length of the bright patch remains same and the patch will not shift also. Got it? Huh? Okay, now the last one more condition. Now let me move the mirror. Earlier I was moving along Y. So here what I do is like I just move parallel to the screen. That's the same conditions. Yeah. Look at this. Now, let L be the length of the mirror and it is moved with uniform velocity. The mirror is moved with a velocity. What will be the speed of the patch on the screen? So what is the question? Find the speed of bright patch formed on the screen. Now what we have to do is like you have to take two positions of the mirror. Okay, there's one position is there. So let me get into the ray diagram part. The initial one I'll show by dotted after reflection. Now the mirror, I'll shift it. It will occupy the new position. So let me take the solid lines for the new portion. So first the they will strike the then you see this. All these are some like a geometry based, no? So definitely little bit some struggle will be there. If you can manage that, I think the geometry part should be very good, the triangles. So most maximum will come across only the triangles condition. No? And now the initial distance, these distances will take it. So they are going to help us a lot. Now you analyze the diagram. So let this be X. This is L. I and from the geometry, okay, we'll do one thing. This is X, no? Okay, no. Huh? I think we were here, no? So the mirror was moving with a velocity V. So let me, how much of distance the mirror has moved? Here you see this one, the distance D. How much the patch has moved here? So this is source S. So we'll take this point as A. And this corresponding point as B. Let this be A dash. Let this be B dash. So what is our interest like? What is A dash? So when this end of the mirror undergoes a displacement. So how much displacement will be equal to D? You can see from clearly. So when the mirror undergoes a displacement D, then what will happen to the, so how much this patch will move, actually this end how much will move, D plus L, then how much this A will move. For the A earlier was for this portion of mirror, the point A was here on the screen. Next short pen corresponding this particular point of the mirror, the A dash will be here. So the displacement of this will, A dash will give the displacement of patch. This is what we have to find out. Okay, for that, let me take help of the conditions available. This distance is L. So this distance should be equal to X plus L. What about this distance will be X plus L plus D. So therefore, what is this distance will be? How much the mirror has undergone displacement. So look at this end. Earlier it was here. Now it is available here. What is the displacement of mirror? L plus D. In that interval of time, the point has shifted from A to A dash, corresponding to this point of the mirror. So if you can calculate A dash, the problem will be solved. That A dash has to be expressed here now. So how to calculate this distance A dash? So now we know this distance will be from year to year, we know L plus X plus D. Okay, this one. And this also X plus L plus D. In that, I should calculate this distance. Okay, so I need some place to do calculation. Let's get into this one. If you can calculate the distance AP, it's old. So what is the distance AP? X plus capital L Small l will take it. Yeah. So many different symbols. This will be x plus, so this will be 2x. So this distance is SP, or we'll do one thing. AP is what? SP minus SA. What is SP? SP will be x plus L. Oh, boy. Oh, sorry. SP is what? X plus L. What is SA? SA is 2x. So this will become L minus x. This is AP. So overall distance A dash will calculate. A dash should be equal to AP plus D plus X plus L plus D. A dash. So what is AP? AP is equal to L minus X. Now, what is the displacement of this end of the mirror? L plus D. Then in time t we'll write it. The displacement of point A, the displacement of spot from point A to A dash is how much? 2 times of L plus D in that interval of time. So what is the conclusion now? So all together, now what we can write it as like, so with what speed the patch will move, therefore, moves with a speed 2v. If the, what is the speed of the mirror? The mirror moves with a speed v. Again, the ray diagram, very, very important. The patch, in fact, will move. What is the patch, sir? I'm not seeing. What do you mean by what you are seeing? The patch. I'll show the patch. The patch earlier was this much. Oh, all the things. This was the patch. Now, finally, what happened? The patch, how much it has become? AB was a patch. Now, A dash, B dash will become the patch. It has undergone displacement. The patch will not be there. Patch will undergo displacement. I'm showing the by color, the patch which was earlier here, now will be available here. I'm keep on writing. Okay, this is screen. Okay, we'll end up the class here. Okay, I think you had some good amount of numericals today, which are more diagram based. No, so as long as you are very good in drawing that ray diagram, the problem becomes very easy. If you don't know ray diagram, no way of understanding these problems. So therefore, I request students to really focus on drawing the ray diagram. What is the ray diagram? From the object, let the rays be incident on the mirror. After reflection from the mirror, okay, they'll go and meet certain point, and there defined laws of reflection, angle of incident, quote, angle of reflection. Search for some triangles or similar triangle. Write some equations. You may reach the answer. This is what today what you have learned almost in every numerical. This was the approach is what we have developed here. So don't try to remember anything here. So try to learn the methodology what your teacher is trying to teach here. The drawing the ray diagram, then immediately the laws of reflection should hold good. then immediately what happened? The geometry part should come into picture to get the unknown things. The methodology is what in today's problem is what we have focused. Okay, now next class will happen. We'll focus on the next set of numericals. Okay, thank you all of you. Take care. Bye. See you.